Good morning, everyone, and thank you for coming here today. Yesterday, we announced new public health rules would kick in from 6 p.m. last night. Thank you to everyone in the community for listening to the health advice and following the directions. On my way home yesterday afternoon, I noticed people were already doing the right thing and putting their masks on. Yet again, the response from Western Australians has been world class. I acknowledge many Western Australians would prefer to not be wearing masks in indoor public venues across the festive season, especially when it's so hot, me included. But the direction is based on health advice, is to keep us safe from any potential risk. And therefore, it is necessary, at least until we know more about any potential spread. I want to nod to the many West Australians who have clearly done the right thing and put their masks on where required. It's really encouraging to see so many of you masking up to protect each other until we know more. Thank you very much. I'd like to acknowledge the workers who are spending their Christmas Eve staffing testing clinics across our city in very hot conditions. To these workers, I say thank you. For those of you who will face queues at testing clinics, please be prepared, please be patient. Our staff are doing the best they can in difficult circumstances. I also want to thank everyone working across vaccination clinics, helping with traffic management around the clinics, and those getting on with the job on the front line yesterday, today, and in the coming days over Christmas. I've just come from an emergency management team meeting, which was held to discuss the potential risks associated with the 25-year-old man who tested positive yesterday. The advice we have received from the Australian Border Force is that the French backpacker arrived in Australia before the onset of the pandemic on January 7, 2020, and has remained in Australia after the last 2 years, or thereabouts. Fast forward to this month, he entered WA on December 12. At the time, Queensland was set as a very low risk jurisdiction, as they had virtually no COVID in that state, which meant people entering WA from Queensland were not required to be vaccinated at that point in time. However, that changed the next day. And now, under our safe transition plan from February 5, everyone who is eligible, aged 12 and over, is required to be double dose vaccinated to enter Western Australia. Obviously, Western Australians are preparing for Christmas celebrations, and we want to be able to bring you as much information as we can. So, I can announce that Western Australia has 4 new local COVID-19 cases as of 9 a.m. this morning. Yesterday, 10,267 tests were taken through public and private clinics across Perth. This is an incredible number, especially given testing didn't ramp up until the afternoon, and especially given the extreme summer weather conditions. It's important people who are lining up are prepared to wait and prepared for very hot conditions. So please bring water and some protection. Clinics were scaled up yesterday and stayed open until 10 p.m. last night. They will keep operating throughout Christmas and Boxing Day. The Health Minister will provide details shortly. I will outline what we know about these cases. The 4 cases. One is a close contact of case 1133, who also attended the mess hall event on Sunday, December 19. The other 3 are casual contacts of case 1133, who also attended the mess hall event but were not known to case 1133. As a result of the high-risk nature of the mess hall event in Northbridge, our health authorities will now upgrade the contact status for the mess hall event. This means that anyone who attended the event must get tested and now self-quarantine for 14 days from the date of exposure. As the date of exposure is the 19th of December, this means they will be in quarantine until January the 3rd. We are making urgent arrangements to ensure everyone who was at the mess hall event, around 400 people, are tested and quarantined appropriately. Now there are 21 close contacts linked to 1133, 9 of whom have tested negative so far, and the 1 positive I mentioned earlier. There are also 991 casual contacts, of which 336 have tested negative so far and 3 positive, as I detailed before. We expect the number of contacts to continue to increase. Last night, Health reported the partner of case 1133 and his four housemates have tested negative. They were all vaccinated. As a result of the mess hall event and the large number of patrons who attended that event, our authorities have quickly responded to limit the spread as much as possible. A high number of patrons have been staying at the Fremantle Old Fire Station Hostel. This morning, WA Police locked down that hostel. As this accommodation is not suitable for people to self-quarantine in, everyone staying in that hostel will now be provided with more suitable accommodation to complete their quarantine period. Overnight, Health has identified new exposure sites across Perth, and these are published on wa.gov.au. These include Montclair Boutique Apartments in East Perth on December 22 and 23, that is yesterday. The Square, Mirrabooka on December 22. New Park Shopping Centre in Girraween on December 18. Vans Shoe Store in the CBD on December 17. Kmart in the Perth CBD on December 17. JB Hi-Fi at the NX Perth Shopping Centre on December 17. McDonald's on Hay Street in the Perth CBD on December 17. H&M in Forest Place on December 17. And the Woolworths St George at the NX Perth Shopping Centre on December 17. A comprehensive list can be found on the wa.gov.au website with all the specific exposure dates and times and quarantine requirements. Please familiarise yourself with these sites, which are updated as our contact tracers keep working and interviewing people to get the latest information. As I said yesterday, I know public health rules are not the news we wanted to hear just before Christmas, but they are necessary. To keep us safe and minimise any potential community spread of the virus, which would have far worse consequences. Now, with the detection of these new cases and the big number of tests are underway, more positive cases are expected, especially as we're still in the infectious period from the exposure date. Therefore, from 6 p.m. tonight, we will introduce an additional public health rule. For all licensed hospitality venues, seated service only will be permitted. This is on top of our public health rules we introduced yesterday, including mask wearing, the dancing ban except at weddings, and the closure of high-risk entertainment venues and large-scale events. The additional seated service only requirement is also in place until Tuesday morning, December 28, which will help us further limit any potential spread of COVID in the community. As I've said before, we want to keep Christmas as normal as possible for Western Australians. The seated service only rule for the next four nights allows for family Christmas lunches and dinners to continue safely as planned. But of course, this rule will mean larger venues, particularly pubs and bars. It will impact their normal trade as everyone will be required to be seated to drink or eat. As a result of these local cases, As a result of these local cases, we are in a holding pattern while we get more tests done and develop a better understanding of the level of community transmission from case 1133. As detailed in our safe transition plan, we'll be introducing a proof of vaccination requirement for a range of venues and events by February 5 or earlier, depending on how this outbreak plays out. This will further protect everyone who has done the right thing and gotten themselves vaccinated. These latest developments are a timely reminder of why it is so important to get vaccinated. Our vaccination rate is 91.3% for first dose 12 plus, and 83.2% for second dose, 12 plus. It's 59.9% first dose for Aboriginal people and 44.7% double dose for Aboriginal people across WA over 12. The vaccine commander told this morning's emergency management team meeting that we've seen an increase in vaccinations since yesterday's developments. Today, the federal government body, ATAGI, has announced changes to increase eligibility for people to get their third doses. From January 4, the interval between the second and third dose will be reduced from 5 months to 4 months. That interval will be reduced further on January 31 to 3 months. The Western Australian Government welcomes this announcement, which I called for at Wednesday's National Cabinet meeting. This means around 630,000 West Australians will be eligible for their third dose come January 4. For parents of children aged 5 to 11 years old, as of this morning, you can now book your kids in for their first dose at a state-run clinic from today for January 10 and beyond. This is obviously great news, which will be welcomed by many families across our state. The Health Minister will walk through these details shortly. I'd encourage all parents to get their children vaccinated from January 10 on, as they would with all other childhood immunisations.